This review is on the movie You Cannot Kill David Arquette. I'm the angry guy, and I'll tell you like it is. Directors for the film was David Darg and Price James. David Darg is an award-winning filmmaker and co-founder of RYOT Media. Named one of Esquire magazine's 2012 Americans of the Year, David spent the last decade as a first reporter and frontline contributor on natural disasters and wars. Price James is a comedy director and screenwriter based between Los Angeles and London, commonly known for comedy, genre, and creative concepts. He is known for the film Action Man, Battlefield Casualties. Believe it or not, David Arquette was a professional wrestler. I didn't believe it either, but in 2000, after filming the World Championship Wrestling movie, Ready to Rumble, David was brought into WCW storylines. During the WCW Thunder on April 26, 2000, David Arquette became the WCW Heavyweight Champion in a special tag match with one special stipulation. The stipulation was that whoever got the pin would become champ, and after his involvement in previous matches, Arquette was able to pin Bischoff and won the title. After winning the WCW World Heavyweight Championship, David Arquette was branded the most hated man in wrestling because he was a non-wrestler and didn't pay his dues to hold the WCW World title. What I told you wasn't a spoiler for the movie because the real story happens 20 years after David Arquette became the WCW Heavyweight Champion. The film is about David Arquette attempting a dangerous return to the world of wrestling while being medicated from a heart attack and two stents placed in him to gain his own self-respect back and earn a place in the professional wrestling. Couple of things I don't understand. David said he doesn't want to be a joke anymore while wearing a purple glass studded wizard cape while sitting on a horse vaping. Arquette claims he had 10 years of rejections in Hollywood because they thought he was a joke in how he won the WCW championship. That's weird because when he became a WCW champion, it was 20 years ago. I felt bad for David watching this film, but after doing my research on David and his different hats he wears during his career, I was definitely impressed. David was an actor, professional wrestler, film director, producer, screenwriter, and fashion designer. Then in my research, I found David Arquette's net worth. I immediately stopped feeling sorry for him. Let's just say Mr. Arquette has done very well for himself. While watching this film, I cringed in discomfort seeing a grown man putting himself through degradation, acts of violence for a true love of a sport. Oh, man. Plus, David seemed like a guy who likes attention sometimes. And sometimes he'll do anything to fill that need. Out of an alphabetic score, I give this film a disquiet C+. Thank you for subscribing, and thank you for commenting. Thank you.